In today's video, I want to find out, can you be a full-time filmmaker, YouTuber, influencer, vlogger, call it what you will, with just a cell phone and the new vlogger kit from Rode. A little inception here for you. This is what I'm filming on. Let's check it out. So I want to try a few different vlogging scenarios, see how it looks and sounds, and then let's also check out what's in the box. Currently, I'm filming on the iPhone 12 mini. I find that it still works and looks great enough. Yeah, for years, I've been a huge fan of just shooting on the smartphone that's in your pocket. There's a lot of benefits to using just your smartphone. A, it might be cheaper, especially if you already have a somewhat newly updated smartphone. The cameras in here are getting really, really good. Over the years, I've made tons of comparisons, and I'm super impressed what they're able to pack inside such a small package. Another benefit is smartphones, they're just small, they're lightweight, you're always carrying it around with you, so to add just a couple little bit of gear items isn't something that's such a big hassle or a stumbling block to really get into more content creation. And then of course the obvious, it's a smartphone, so you can shoot, you can edit, and then you can post all from that one device. All right, let's start with a few audio tests and comparisons. This is just the standard microphone built into the iPhone. We're in a pretty controlled studio environment. There's not much background noise going on, so this is the default built-in microphones. And now let's switch over to the video mic, see how that sounds. All right, and now this is recording through the Rode mic. How does it sound? How does it compare? I'm still here in the studio, not much background noise, but it should still be improvement, hopefully. Another thing I love about a little microphone like this is that there's no external power needed, no cables, no internal AAA batteries or those micro things that are found in a watch that you can never find. It's powered directly through the port. Simple. Clean. Now, of course, they have other models, one mic that has a USB Type-C for Androids and those sort of devices, and then also there's a standard 3.5mm mic ported version as well. Now, while that cabled version allows you to make it usable with other cameras and phones, I kind of prefer the minimalism of the iOS Lightning ports plugged directly into the phone for a little bit more minimalistic style. And next up, we're down here at the lake. It's a little windy, cloudy, overcast. This is the built-in microphone on the iPhone 12 mini. Okay, and now this is the Rode video mic plugged into the iPhone. Does it sound any different? Can you hear some of that wind background noise? Now this audio on the video mic is without the wind. And a quick editor's note, see how the audio cut out right there? It's literally muted, and then it happened a little bit later down on the timeline. That's not good, and I'm not sure what caused it. If I put this guy on, does it sound any better? Maybe some better background wind reduction. Now let's put on the windscreen and see how that sounds. Now you can see some of the furries in camera frame. Normally you could push those over, but just for the sample shot, I'm gonna leave it there so that we know that it's on. It's blowing pretty windy down here. Going for a little jog. We're on the ultra wide lens on the iPhone. How's it look? How's it sound? Ooh, next, we're gonna jump on the e-bike with the dead cat, muffle out some of that wind noise and see how it looks and sounds. All right, now that wind is really picking up. So how does the microphone sound? I can show you in just a second what the default built-in phone microphones will sound like, but they are really bad usually in high winds. Right now we are cruising along. It's super windy out here. And yeah, am I a real vlogger now? I will say, after getting that A7S recently, that thing is a hoss to hold out for long periods of time. I mean, I do work out and stuff. No, I don't, but seriously, having something lightweight like this with just a phone, little LED light, lightweight microphone, lightweight tripod, adds a lot of freedom and flexibility with just your everyday shooting needs. And now, just for fun, let's unplug that microphone and see how it sounds and compares. Okay, just for proof, here it is, unplugged, put it in my pocket, jump back on the old e-bike. Now I'm using the ultra wide angle lens on here, not because it has the best quality, the primary is actually a lot better, but I'm able to hold the phone just a couple feet away from my face and get my whole head and some torso and some of the background scenery in shot. So how's that audio sound? It is windy down here. How's it compared to that Rode mic? And a quick editor's notes. The audio from the built-in microphones on the iPhone was actually a lot better than I thought it was gonna be. It sounded a little bit more full sounding, a little bit louder. However, with the windscreen, with the video mic from Rode, it still did a little bit better job of reducing some of that loud wind background noise. So it was a little bit closer in competition than I thought it would be, but I think in some situations, this directional microphone is gonna be the better bet. And make sure you guys let me know down in the comments which one you think sounded better.
So how does the microphone sound?
So how does that audio sound? It is windy down here. Now, one wishlist item I have with this tripod mount, I like it, but I wish there's a little bit of that telescoping extension rod built in, like this one from PGY Tech. It extends out, so that way I don't always have to use that ultra wide lens when I'm rear facing. Even the front facing camera is a little bit narrow. To have that extra reach on a rod like this, boom, you can fit more scenery, more face, whatever in your shot. Get up high, get down low. It telescopes in and out. It's still lightweight and portable. I'll give you this link down below. I would love to see this sort of extension rod built into this tripod setup. Another small wishlist item on this microphone, I wish it rotated or tilted, kind of like this MV88. It'd be nice to film this way and then flip it back, voice, aim it, direction. That'd be kind of nice, but unfortunately it's locked. So the only way is to unplug, flip it around. All right, now let's talk about the micro LED up top. I'm usually not a huge fan of these up here, mainly because well, they're pretty harsh. It's a small source of light. And when it's back on your face, it kind of gives that news reporter feel, which I'm not a huge fan. But a few nice little bonus options. We can put it all the way low power. We can clip on their little diffuser thing so it softens it up a bit. Okay, there we go. Now what I can do is turn off the studio lights in here so it looks a little bit more normal lighting. You usually wouldn't have all this fancy lighting. And you can see that it adds a nice little fill and recording like this, wham, bam. Now, however, something that I like even a little bit more, if we take off this guy and maybe put it off axis at 45-ish degrees, can lift it up a little bit. Well, there you go. It's already starting to look a little bit better. Now, if you had a little bit of piece of paper or cloth, you could diffuse it. That might be nice. Or another idea that I kind of like, some of these little gel screens that they come in the kit. A little finicky, doesn't want to clip in there. We can throw it on a little stick here if you have this tripod or something. Maybe using this as a little set piece design so we could put it back here, let's say in one of the cubes. And check that out. Sweet little red background glow for your set. You see this little plant back here? Boom, you could put it there. Just add nice little touches of light. So overall, I'd rate this whole kit maybe like a B or B plus. It's 150 bucks, which isn't cheap, but when you start to add up all the items together, it actually seems like a pretty good bang for your buck if you're looking at all these items together. For example, the microphone, that Shure one that I showed you earlier, is 150 bucks alone. If you're looking for an LED light like this guy, there's this cute tiny one from GoPro. This thing is 50 bucks. If you want a nice little tripod and stand, that's gonna go for around 30, maybe 40 bucks, depending on which one. So again, add it all up and you're around the 150 buck mark. All these things feel like a pretty premium quality. I just wish that microphone sounded a little bit better. Then it would go A plus from my book. The Rode Go is one of my favorite microphone systems. It's wireless, it's a little bit more expensive, but check out my review if you want something wireless. All right, that's it for today, guys. I'll see you next time.